or soul. Your dynamic host and founder, Sue Lundquist, will bring you her own intuitive talents and gifts for co-creating, healing, and teaching. Her show, The Gratitude Cafe, Positive Radio to Feed Your Soul, is focused on bringing you to a higher place each week where you can leave the hustle of life at the door. So pull up a chair and join us for The Gratitude Cafe, Positive Radio to Feed Your Soul.
Good morning, everybody. Hello, radio world. Hello, YouTube, Insta. Hi, Benny. Good morning, love. How are you?
Good morning. Good morning. Oh, let me turn on my camera.
Oh, there you are. Oh.
Hello.
Oh.
Sorry for the tardiness.
Oh, you got busy Washington morning. State morning. Sweatshirt on, don't you?
Go Cougs. Go Cougs.
Go Cougs. You know, we have two Cougs in the house.
It's true. And maybe more in the future.
Actually, you know what? She committed to somewhere else, and I haven't been given permission to say where she's going.
Oh, okay.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, well, she's already been taking, referring to Lexi, obviously. She's been taking college credits already.
Good. Congratulations. And for the forward thinking, that's good. I was thinking actually even past that, even.
Oh, like they're going to have kids later.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Come on, Benny, help me out here.
You should know.
Much later. We got a few years. Come on, help me out.
Future Cougs.
No cooging it. Not with that. No. Oh, that. Okay. Anyways. Hi, everybody.
I'm not going to say
it. No. We'll just stop right there. Hello. Welcome to the Gratitude Cafe. Sue Lundquist here. I'm your host. We are going to have a lot of fun today. I had an original guest, however, and it's Jack Stafford. And he is, believe it or not, he's a self-help songwriter. Now, the deal is this. He's in the UK. And there has been some connection issues and stuff like that. So if he doesn't, if we can't get a hold of him or if he doesn't call in, all of that stuff, we will reschedule, because I was pretty excited to have him on because I hadn't heard of a songwriter that specifically spoke to serving and promoting spiritual, physical, and well-being. So I thought that that would kind of totally jive with what we're doing. Don't you think, Benny?
Well, yeah, our people are tracking down his people. That's basically what we're trying to do.
Yes, our peoples are tracking down your people. But in the meantime, I'm going to remind all of you how to get a hold of me, which of course is SueLundquist.com. If you want the newsletter and or you want to get a follow-up with any of the goings-ons, the meetings, the live radio show, the CDC challenge, I do free card pulls and reading every single week. So you guys get that on the newsletter. And it's a really good reminder and just kind of sets the tone for the week. You know, and again, you take what resonates and leave the rest. That's what this is all about. And it is all about a new perspective, new thoughts, new ideas, a new you, whatever resonates with you. Now, I would like to have a little disclaimer and a little conversation about that, because in anything that I have come across when I'm learning, and sometimes it'll resonate and I'll be like, oh, that didn't really hit well. And then I'll go back even an hour later, reread it, and I'll be like, oh, okay. Or a year later. So just have, again, the CCs, compassionate curiosity for yourself, and just get curious and open. Just have an open mind. Now, for all of you just tuning in and don't know a lot about me, I do a lot of growth mindset work, strategy, self-regulating tools, all of which, of course, that I had to learn myself going through all of my situations and opportunities in life. And if you want to get more information about that, you want to get some free videos, of course, go to SueLundquist.com/C2C. And we're talking about transition. We're talking about shedding old belief systems. We're talking about relationships. We're talking about old habits that are attached to said relationships, whether that's business, work, children, all of the above. How do I keep myself sustained in love and compassion versus being or allowing? Because remember, we talked about this before. A trigger is your 100% responsibility. So when you hear somebody say, you know what, you're really triggering me, you know what? That's on them, because they have lived that life. They have lived that circumstance that created that experience and that nervous system reaction that's going on in their body. Now, again, a disclaimer, if there are unhealthy relationships that you are in and they are purposefully, you know, badgering you, there's a difference, screaming, that's completely different. That's abusive kind of stuff. And you want to completely disassociate yourself with that. I'm talking about you in the relationship with your inner dialogue and how you are self-regulating and what's happening with the mindset inside and what's happening with your heart. We have 40,000 neurons. You know what that means? In our heart. That means that heart is beautiful and expansive and so smart. So why wouldn't we want to be listening to 40,000 neurons in that big, beautiful heart? Why not? Right? All right. So with that being said, you can go to SueLundquist.com and you can sign up for the mini live C2C that we do. Or you can, of course, do my one-on-one coaching, which I absolutely love to do. And we are launching a new Facebook Live every Sunday. And I'll come on and I'll just kind of noodle around with you guys. It's going to be authentic and genuine. And sometimes I'm going to know what I'm going to want to say. And sometimes I might not. And I'm going to wing it. But I for sure will be loving and supporting and enticing you guys into that yummy, juicy mindset, good stuff. And then we'll also talk about who's coming up for the radio show. Benny, you have some news?
I was just typing it to you. Behind the scenes type. We've got our guest. He's currently getting situated, so we need a couple of minutes.
Not a problem. So with that, we are going to, I'll do an introduction. And then while Jack's getting ready, I want to talk to you guys. I had read and pulled a card. It was actually, it was actually beautiful because it's so crazy that these messages can be so timely and so appropriate. I got this new, it's called 333 Oracle Heart Wisdom Card. So of course, 40,000 neurons in the heart. And this is by Alana Fairchild. She's one of my favorite, one of the top three that I've got cards from and this beautiful book that I read from. And I pulled, I didn't pull a card. I intuited, just kind of opened the book and what we needed to hear, what the message needed to be as a collective. And the message was this, and it's so beautiful. I talked about it on Sunday for the Facebook Live, but, and again, talking about the Sunday show, it was all about surrendering into love and trust. And that heart is pretty smart with all those neurons in there. So this is called The Unscripted Journey. And again, it's from Alana Fairchild, this beautiful little book right here, Oracles of the Heart. It's absolutely stunning. The path that you now tread is delicious and confluence of divine destiny and unscripted spontaneous life. To embrace this journey, remember that change can bring such blessings. You may be surprised on how much you can leave behind now. That is really important. And without feeling concerned or anxious, you will be able to travel lighter than you've ever imagined, just as the butterfly leaves the chrysalis behind. And when it's time to spread its newly formed wings, so shall you too be ready to leave behind what once held you back or held you within. In order to expand according to the natural evolution of your soul, I talk about iterations, evolutions of your soul, the past has served its purpose. So bless it, love it, and say thank you. You can feel good about what has been and about where you're going and headed. This oracle brings confirmation of significant change taking place in your life according to the inner timing and awakening of your soul. Trust in the natural timing of your own emergence. Again, trust, surrender into love and trust. Hey, hello, babe. Hi.
Hello, Sue.
How are you, love?
I'm lovely. It's lovely to see you.
Thank you. Welcome.
I'm lovely.
Yeah, so it's not to be confused. That's our guest now because I can't do an accent that amazing.
Yes.
Jack Stafford has joined the show today for everyone on the screens.
True.
There.
Hi, love. And from the UK, right? Whereabouts?
I'm from the UK, but I'm actually in Italy. It's just to make it even more adorable.
Wow.
Where in Italy? I've got family and friends and family. They're my family. Where are you at in Italy?
I'm right in the south, about an hour and a half south of Napoli, opposite the Amalfi Coast.
Oh, my to-do list.
Yeah.
Is that so sexy and beautiful? Oh, my God.
I'm living your to-do list.
You are living my to-do list. Oh, I love it. I love it. I was just in Italy a few years ago in Florence and Sardinia, it was just incredible. But yes, the Amalfi Coast is for sure on my to-do list. Okay, Jack, welcome. And for the radio world, welcome, Jack, and the YouTubers. So we're live on YouTube, and you can say hi to everybody. They're saying hi to you. So I love this, songwriting and music to serve others and promote spiritual, physical, and mental well-being. Jack, that's beautiful. I would do the formal introduction, and I can totally do that if you want me to, but I want to jump in. I want to hear your story. I want the audience to just hear you because it comes best from you, right?
Well, where to start? I mean, I was a traveling troubadour before I settled in Italy. I used to do couch concerts going around the world. So I would roll up in a town and play in someone's living room for their friends and family,
nice.
Telling the stories of my adventure in true troubadour style and keep them entertained for an evening. But then something rolled around called COVID. I don't know if you've heard of this.
No.
You have? No? Doesn't reach you?
Maybe just a little. Yeah.
Yeah. So I had to think of another. The world was turned upside down. So I had to think of plan B. So... And I've always been serving people with my songs. I'm kind of a documentary songwriter. I write about my experiences. But that got a bit repetitive, you know. I did Mind, Body, Spirit albums. So I've gone through that journey as well with Ayurveda and health and well-being and the meditation of the mind. So when we were all locked in our houses around the world, I'm actually in my meditation room now and I've foamed it all up.
I see that.
Because I started doing this podcast called Pod Songs, so I interview people around the world and I finished the interview by writing a song about them.
Ah, that's beautiful.
Yeah. So I'm turning my skills. I mostly interview people who are in service to others, like charities or peace workers or, well, lots of professors and doctors as well, but they're teaching and they're serving. So I write songs about books, a lot of songs about books, causes. A song can be just inspired by the interview. So there could be strange subjects, and then you get strange songs. You get some songs are not as good as others, but then that's the fault of the guest.
That's good.
Yes.
That's good. I want to tell everybody how to get a hold of you. And of course, I want to, in the bio, it talks about you being in Italy and all the different experiences. And within those different experiences, it was an evolution. And I love how the theme, and when I started off, I was talking about the unscripted journey and what that looks like. And of course, here we are talking about your journey, moving through music, inspiring others from living rooms, and then you being able to then turn the tables, interview them, but then also gift it back. I love that, you know, it's that collaborative win-win loving energy. I love that. I absolutely love that. I really do, because it's a synergy, right? And with like mind, we're all that tribe. Talk to me about how do you, because music to me, and you may understand this. So for years, my nervous system, my body was in fight or flight, adrenal failure, all that. And I couldn't slow things down enough to hear the lyrics of the music. I could hear the, there was something, it was hard, right? And that was more in my teen years. And as I changed my neural pathways and the evolution of that, I started really hearing the poetry and the language from the music, and I'm digging it now. I'm like, I'm finding all these incredible artists that I can hear, and I call it the feels with the Z. I can feel it in my body, and I love that. And that's kind of like what I'm feeling from you and what's happening and how you do that and bring that up for your music or with your music.
Oh yeah, I know what you mean. People we're all stimulated, and when you're in a stimulated state, you tend to move towards the greater stimulation. So, you have a cup of coffee, and then I have a great chat with you. So then afterwards, I have to go for a run, and then I need a drink, and then so it's up and up and up, and it's hard to come down, and that's what what we all need to do to counteract this and realize not to keep running on the hamster wheel.
Oh, I love that. That's my analogy. Yeah. We have a shared analogy. Yeah, it's totally the hamster wheel. Absolutely. Walk me through a day and a life of your songwriting. Is that something that, I mean, I know you were talking about your podcast, but are you still actively doing other writing amongst yourself?
Well, I've no time now, to tell the truth, because I am in typical, probably overachiever, you know, I'm doing 3 episodes a week. So that's 3 songs. Yes, that's an album a month, about 160 songs a year. So yeah, there's not much time for much else, really, I'm afraid.
No, but how juicy. Go ahead.
Well, I'm getting into quite a groove, you know. So I just interviewed a guest, and then I was working on the song straight away. And then I mix the podcast and I demo it. And then once a week, I go into the studio and these are full production songs. So they're not just me on the guitar. We have a multi-instrumentalist and a producer. So, and the songs are released on Spotify every 3 times a week as well.
Okay.
And iTunes and Deezer. So,
okay.
So it's like, and I don't think, you know how an airplane to take off needs, you know, a strong breeze, you know, under the, so if I was just doing one episode a week or a month, I wouldn't get enough. I need this momentum. I need it to be all consuming, or I wouldn't be able, I'd get distracted by something else. But once it's all consuming like this, especially, I mean, here in Italy, you know, we have quite a serious lockdown. I mean, twice last year, I think for 2 months, we weren't allowed outside the house. So, yeah.
No, see, yeah, you can't cage this kid.
Mm-mm. No. But it did, you know, I poured all the energy into the podcast. So this is a real, I mean, I've heard some other artists talking about how, I think King Lear was written in a quarantine, and Newton's of mathematics formulas, he was in the quarantine, because quarantine in Latin, quarantine, yeah.
Wow.
So they would have these lockdowns before, you know, when the plague was made COVID look like a mild cold. So
flu, yeah.
Behind any mathematical formulas. Yeah.
Yes. Well, we could go into the conversation. And so I've got some friends, and I'm just going to kind of segue just a little bit, and we'll probably take a break about 8:30. And I also advocate for the audience too. And I've got friends that are songwriters. Is there a piece of wisdom or pieces of wisdom that you can offer to them? Because we've got listeners as well that are also songwriters. And I've got friends, you know, California, Utah, Mexico, yeah, all over. And they're like, you have a songwriter, really? And I'm like, yeah, you just wait till you hear what he's doing. So how will you speak to them? Because I'm not familiar. I would love to get your wisdom and some ahas or some pearls that we can offer them.
Well, I think service to others is a big takeaway. If you do that in any aspect of your work, then the rest takes care of itself. So my first project before I started my first pandemic project was my music video. My music video shoot was cancelled to a song called Background Worry. And it's a song, it's a meditative song about the voice in your head, you know, the conscious mind is all causing all your problems. But I couldn't shoot the video for it. So I had to reach out online to people who were also in lockdown around the world. And I got them all, I wanted them all to sing the video, lip sync it instead of me. And I'd cut them all together. But I was a problem, because I know all the lyrics, I've memorized them. But if I can't ask people to memorize a whole song, I mean, that's a lip sync. I mean, that's asking too much. So from a problem, you get a beautiful solution. So the problem here, I solved it by dividing the verses by age category. So the young toddlers sing the first verse, teenagers, middle age, and then old people at the end. And it's a song. The lyrics are about worrying your way through life, worrying yourself to death.
Yes.
You really get that poignancy when you see children starting up. Say, background worry in my mind, all are always craving. So...
I love that. And that's a feels too, right? Because you can see the evolution, the process.
Yes. Yeah. Yeah. It's really poignant when you see old people at the end and how quickly it all goes, all gets baggy.
Yeah, from diapers to diapers or something like that. I mean, that's a good analogy, but in love. I want to talk to you, and of course I've got interview topics, the effects of mantra, prayer, all of that. And you incorporate that with the music, and if I'm not mistaken, right? I mean, go ahead.
Yeah, I mean, I did a lot of meditation before. My last album before this project was called Deeper, which is a lot of meditation songs, like The Voice in Your Head and Background Worry, Master of Your Mind, things like that. And then, so it's turning into a bit of a trilogy. It was going to be a bit of a trilogy because I had kind of a spiritual awakening when I was in India.
Yes.
And I had, I started waking up every night at 3:33.
Of course you did.
Yeah. So, you know, it's like, you know, Groundhog Day, rolling over. Oh, there we go.
That was the message that I read today from 333. Of course.
Wow.
Of course.
Synchronicity. So it's like an angel number or something. It's someone's, I don't know, it's your higher self is trying to get through to you, or you've got some friends trying. I don't know what it was. I still don't. So yeah, someone knocking on the door. And so, you know, I Googled it, as you do. You Google everything. What does this mean?
Yep.
So... And there's quite a few videos on it saying, look out for other synchronicities in your daytime. So I did, you know, and I started seeing Kundalini everywhere. Someone mentioning Kundalini books to me, and there was I was staying behind a Kundalini center for 3 weeks and I didn't know it was there.
Wow.
So I started researching Kundalini, and the Bible of Kundalini is called The Serpent Power. Which, because serpent, it goes up your spine when you raise Kundalini. It's like a serpent, apparently. I don't know. I'm not a master of yoga yet. But so I started watching this, because it's a very complicated book. I mean, it's deep Sanskrit.
Yeah.
And
read a little bit, put it down, process, right? Yeah.
Oh,
yeah.
But I couldn't even get into it. So I watched you. I turned to Google, you know, as we do. YouTube.
Yeah,
my source of knowledge for everything in my life. And I found a really good video class from an American yogi. So I'm in India, you know.
Yeah.
I want to see a Sadhguru. I want to get spiritual enlightening. I want to have a spiritual moment from somebody in robes, or, you know, someone with a halo. Unfortunately, I get it through YouTube. This big American guy looks like a quarterback. And it's called Nehemiah Davis. And he's a master of yoga. Well, he's not, I'm sorry, not a master, but he is a very advanced for me. And he goes through all these Sanskrit terminology and talks through it very well. He's got a channel called Mystic Knowledge.
Okay.
And he kind of breaks down all these, because yoga in the West has been kind of diluted into like asanas, you know, but really it's, the real yoga is, well, karma yoga is the number one, service to others, which anyone can do, you know, so you don't need any Sanskrit for that. But for the mantra and pranayama, that's kind of the real, that's what really pumps up your nadis and, you know, takes you up to your game, that kind of.
Completely. Talk about the feels.
Right.
Yeah. And then when you have that Kundalini awakening, for those of you on YouTube, you see my finger spiraling up, but for those of you in radio world, it's the rebirth. It's the awakening. It's that power source and that energy popping up. I remember when I had mine, and I was actually in a steam room, and I wasn't quite sure what was happening. And all of a sudden, and I'm in just bliss, right? And I'm sitting there and I could feel the energy coming up. And all of a sudden, and this is the beautiful, I'm humbled by this work always. I'm sure you can attest to that, Jack, that I had these big, massive white wings pop out of my spine. And then I'm still, and I can still tap into that frequency and that energy, like with love and nurturing and
wow.
So when I embrace people, that's what comes up. It's the, and I'm getting tingles. I just have these beautiful white angelic feathers out of my spine. I don't ask why. I just am like, okay. I call it God, universe, spirit, source, you know, whatever you want. It could be chopsticks if that's what you wanted. Okay, you know what? It is about 8:30. Let's take a quick commercial break. We'll get settled in. We're still going to be live on YouTube for those of on YouTube or Radio World. If you want to find us on YouTube, just go to YouTube and type in 1150. Again, we're talking to the self-help songwriter, Jack Stafford. We will be right back. Sue Lundquist with the Gratitude Cafe.
Ground worry going on. All are always craving. With urges or aversions for different things, different versions, all just worry.
Yeah! Thank you, Benny.
God,
that's my
a good man behind the desk there.
Oh, that is Benny. Thank you very much. Wow. Okay, for the YouTuber world, I'm going to give you some information how to get a hold of Jack. It actually, you know what, I have this stuff on the website, but you can go in his name. I'm going to spell it all out for you. It's the foundation. Is that where you want them to go?
It's actually podsongs.com. I've got three different URLs, but it just all goes to the same website now.
Pod. Yeah. Okay, let me rewrite that because that's not on here. What is it?
Podsongs.com.
That's what I wrote up here. Okay. Oh, there it is. All right.
And on all the on YouTube, on all those, on also on the sort of the podcast apps,
all under
pod songs everywhere. Pod songs, yeah.
Okay, on here they've got all of your just your first and last name stuff. Okay,
right
on your this form. Okay,
yeah, that was probably before I started Pod Songs. So
yeah,
I only started in November, so it's really new.
Wow. Okay, yeah. So to all of those in YouTube world, podsongs.com, you can go to hear Jack, see Jack, right? Seeing, hearing, and all of your guests that come on. And you were saying more specifically, it's like service.
I like to, I mean, yeah.
Because, and people with books and that are being.
Yeah. And if they're not that interesting, maybe a charity they're working for. Some, I've done lots of charities. So yeah.
Got you. Okay. Yeah. And when I think of service minded, I think it's quite, you know, everybody that I interview, quite honestly, because we are in the rink and showing up and shining the light through adversity and through opportunities, right? I call them opportunities. You can adjective them all you want, but they're opportunities, right?
Yeah.
So it's being in the rink and shining your light and showing up the best that you can.
I did. Well, I was a bit loose with some areas of that. Like in the beginning, I had Alan Dershowitz on, the lawyer. So he's in service to others, but they pay him. So,
Hey, there's all different kinds, right?
Yeah.
There really is. And, you know, and quite honestly, what is meant to show up and to be heard, it's supposed to be there. It really
he's
is.
Done a lot for free speech, Fred.
Yeah, let's go.
All right, stand by.
That way, bring some peace back to your life. If it's impossibly hard, then you'll see that you're scarred from all of the stress you've built up. Background worry in my mind.
Oh, okay. So if you're digging on that music like I am, Benny, thank you, my wonderful producer.
Oh, well, don't thank me. Thank Jack. That's an amazing video. Like, I'm watching it while, I mean, his description was perfect. I mean, he sent out all the lyrics. I mean, it's really good. All the people involved in the video, you guys got to go check this out on YouTube. So.
Okay. And it's on it's Pod Songs on YouTube.
Actually, that one's just Jack Stafford. Sorry to confuse everyone. <but yeah. laughs>
Hang on here. I'm trying to promote you, babe.
I know. I'm making your life difficult.
Okay. On YouTube, to see that beautiful video, they go to your first and last name.
Jack Stafford, Background Worry. Yeah. Yeah.
There we go. Perfect. Yeah. And I will get that posted for all of you guys as well. Beautiful. I'm excited to see that. Okay. So at the top of the hour, we were talking about Jack's journey and the journey through India, but also journey through yogi, journey through music, journey through the COVID, and how that's all transpired into your life and the guests that you now have on podsongs.com. And then we kind of got into a little bit of a conversation about inspiring those that are new songwriters and kind of bustling around with that and talking about that. I don't know that we quite finished that. So do you want to loop back around and look at that again?
Sure. Well, yeah, I mean, three chords in the truth is a good way to sum it up. You know, have some truths.
Yeah.
And you know, that, you know, these days there's so many songs which are, you know, the lyrics are kind of written at the end as an afterthought, you know, beats and melody. And, but really, I think if you just try and write a song that has a point to it, you know, you've got so many opportunities to strike, you know, you strike lucky, because even if they don't like the music, they don't like the melody, they still, that's a poignant message. So yeah, you definitely want to cover that base.
I love that. The message, the poignant message, but even more so that what's coming up for me, Jack, is that vulnerability to open up your heart, that vulnerability to speak that language and it's that language to shine the light on whatever the situation may be. And I love that.
Yeah, that's really important.
Oh, so audience, did you hear that? To all the new songwriters, and these are big words for me and they're like anchoring words. So I make choices daily, hourly on this. If it's not authentic and genuine, it's just like, it's like that anchor, right? So yeah, look at that for yourselves, for all of you that are out there and songwriting, you know, it's the message and it's authentic and it's genuine, and it's vulnerable and it's truth, right?
Yeah.
It's beautiful. And then we talked about, your experience in India and the Kundalini. I kind of went in there and talked about my experience just to share with the audience that it happens. Do you want to expand any more on that?
Well, I haven't had any wonderful experiences like that, unfortunately. I mean, I've been doing the pranayama and the mantra, but for me, it's more, I mean, knowing that reincarnation, you know, learning that reincarnation is factual thing. You know, it's taken out of the Bible in about 500 AD. Christianity is based on reincarnation and in all the religions. And yeah, that kind of really makes it so much more, you know, meaningful when you realize that you're going round and round and coming back.
The soul's up. Makes,
yeah. Yeah. So, you know, if you kind of,
if that's what you want to believe, I mean, if that's what resonates, right. I mean, that for me, for sure, but go ahead. Yeah,
I mean, if you study it, I think a lot of the people who don't believe is because they just dismiss it and they haven't really studied it. But there are many, many research. There's the University of, I think it's Virginia, has a whole department called Perpetual Studies, and they research it and they collect evidence and testimonies from children. And so, yeah, I mean, people coming back with birthmarks where they were damaged in the previous life. And so, yeah.
Oh, there's all kinds of happening. Yeah.
So once you really look into it, there's enough evidence, you know, there's more evidence than you could, if you're having a murder trial, you could put more evidence for reincarnation to convict someone. So
yeah. Take the power back, you guys.
Yeah.
Do the research for yourself. And again, feel what resonates with you and feel into that and feel what's right for you. Talking about the feels and the music, let's talk about your latest album, Deeper. Mm-hmm. Walk us through that. Like Brené Brown would say, unpack that for us.
Well, that was going to be the middle song in, because I was very into Ayurveda. That's what got me to India. Because I had, you know, being a troubadour, traveling around, eating whatever. You get a bit messed up in your second brain. And so I got into Ayurveda really as a way to come back to myself, you know, get my body, because if your body's out of whack, then it's very hard to get your mind, you know, and it's very hard to master your mind if your body's out of whack, vice versa. So yeah, the Ayurveda was amazing. I think it should be taught in primary schools. You know, it's seasonal eating, you know, eat the food that's in that's right now. You know, your digestion is stronger in the winter, so you can eat the wheat and the seeds and things like that. And then in spring, there's nothing, you know, there's a few shoots and a few leaves, not very much, you know. And then the summer, you put on weight and you eat the cooling foods, and then through, you know, your digestive fire changes throughout the whole year. So you know, if a deer eats out of season, it can die. And just because we think we're living in insulated boxes that we're divorced from that, but we're not. We're very you know, our microbiome and our whole, they have this seasonal cycle. So, you know, following the Ayurveda really helped me get my life back on track and, you know, getting my health. And I wrote a whole album of songs about that. I took the Sanskrit teachings and I made them rhyme in English, and I put songs, did songs. Yeah.
And that is the latest one, Deeper.
That was the one before. That was the Shtanga Harindium. Yeah.
Oh, wow. Okay. Yeah. I've got to get all these lined up. Okay. So for your podcast, podsongs.com, and for the music, the latest music, that's your actual
name. That's also on podsongs.com. I have the same different URLs for the same website.
Okay. So. But it was YouTube that was your name, and that's Jack Stafford, for those of you.
I'm on Spotify and iTunes and Deezer. You can listen to all the music and all the albums. So.
Oh, fantastic. What? When? Why? Benny, I'm sorry.
No, I'm not quite finished, Sue. Sorry about that. Just
no problem. Going. I got sidetracked. All right, guys. So again, Gratitude Cafe. Thank you so much, you guys, on the radio world and also the YouTube. It says here, making music videos, background worry, featuring 90 people. That was the one that we were listening to. And I want everybody to see that. I'm going to go look at that when we get done here. And I love that you gave not only the visual, but the feels from younger to older, that whole evolution of growth through that. What's coming up for you now for, you know, educating the audience, talking about the love of music? And I think more so for me, what's coming up, it's the love of service and how you're providing that service for what you do. Can we kind of walk through that and inspire the audience on how that's shown up for you?
Sure. Well, I mean, you know, writing songs for these guests. I mean, tomorrow I'm speaking to Lawrence Krauss, who's quite a famous physicist. I've spoken with famous psychiatrists like Stephen C. Hayes, the lawyer Alan Dershowitz. I had him on, wrote a song called Unbendable for him, about Sean Carroll, another famous physicist, AJ Jacobs.
Lots of physicists, lots of nerdy stuff in there. I love that. Why are you drawn to that?
Well, I reached out between you and me, if we don't tell anyone else. I reached out to all the guests of the major other podcasts, like, you know, Joe Rogan and things like that. And the people who responded, I had on the show. So
got you. Okay.
You know, I'm looking for people with big followings and and then I make work with what I can get. But I've got some very interesting people who are, you know, I combine the two. So big people and also people that I find interesting as well.
That's me too, because you can be inspired and learn from the shop owner that's right next door that has an inspiring message in a book, you know, to the Oprahs or whoever it is that you're interviewing. Yes. Yeah. Go ahead. I'm sorry, Jack.
Yeah. But no, my next guest is Lawrence Krauss. And you need the big people to get in there, because these people, if you've got hundreds of thousands of followers on Twitter and they tweet about each episode, it really helps to build the audience and people who are, you know, fans of the book. If you've read the book about acceptance commitment therapy and then you hear the song about it, it really connects you much more. So this is a way for my songs to touch more area. I've written a song about, you know, logotherapy or urine therapy or you know, crazy subjects that I would never write about, but just because I've had a guest about it. You know, I had like Eric Topol, who's the most famous doctor in America. He's the most cited doctor, and so I've written a song for him about, because he started this new foundation to get doctors to unite, because you know, all the doctors' organizations, the cardiologists have their organization, the radiographers have their organization. There's not going to be a white coat revolution, and the doctors got told to stay in their lane by NRA. Yeah, the National Rifle Association told doctors to stay in their lane because they started to criticize the NRA for the doctors told that maybe you should limit the number of assault weapons you have in your house. Maybe you only need to keep it under 100, you know, or something like that. And then they got told to stay in their lane, and they the doctors really united and said, every lane is our lane, you know, because I'm pulling bullets out of corpses here every day, you know. So, but there wasn't really a, you know, the doctors in America are not united in the way that they could be, because they could, you know, the song goes, you know, the solution, the remedy is universal. Doctors unite, you know. You don't need dietitians to solve the obesity crisis, or more medical administrators to solve the short visiting times, but the remedy is universal. Get doctors to unite.
Nice. And bringing people together, bringing that all together in a song, right?
Exactly. Yeah. Just something, a 3-minute anthem for the doctors. Yeah.
Oh, do you guys catch that? It's a 3-minute anthem. I love that. And bringing it all together. Next steps for you.
I'm just doing Pod Songs 2.0 now. So we're going to, because I've sung 70. Yeah, I've sung 70 songs in the last 6 months. So I'm getting tired of the sound of my own voice. So I'm going to bring in guest musicians to help interview the guests and sing the song. So this will also be a way to, you know, also get a broader audience, because the band's more audience, you know. So I'm seeing in 2 or 3 years, you've got, you know, Bono interviewing the Dalai Lama or Pod Songs, that kind of thing.
Right.
So this kind of cumulative effect, you know. So now I'm just getting smaller musicians interviewing guests, but hopefully I can get more and more. There's a bit of an issue with the publishing, because songwriters are signed, many musicians are signed to record companies and publishers. So I have to overcome that hurdle, but I'm starting with the smaller artists.
Well, with this, but if you guys, meaning you and your other artists that you're interviewing the guest, it's you two creating that music, right? So there wouldn't be any, right? Yeah, there wouldn't be any infringements, or would there? I don't know.
Well, when you're a musician, you sign to a producer, you sign to a publisher or a record company. So you agree all your music is released through them. You know, you're like in a stable, you're like a horse in a stable. But yeah, I mean, I'm going to try and do it. And, you know, if you look at the big artists, like, you know, Kanye West has 17 collaborators on every song, you know. So because we're fighting against the algorithm, because we get paid 0.0034 cents per play. So if you want to buy me a cup of coffee, you have to go now onto Spotify and listen 1,000 times to my song.
Wow.
So I get, you know, it's better for the big artists.
That's important. So if we're going to support these beautiful artists like Jack himself, I'm going to totally plug this. And I didn't know that, because I just don't know the back side, the business side of it too, because there's a practicality too, because you wouldn't be doing this. You've got to make money to live in 3D. I mean, to feed yourself that beautiful body and to sustain yourself in a healthy way so you can keep creating like this. So for those of you listening, you can go to Spotify, and if you want to hear it 1,000 times over and over, you barely got him a cup of coffee. So let's spread the love, share the love, get it out there where this is, you know, like myself and like Jack, it's being of service, because we truly, genuinely, authentically love what we're doing. And there's so much value and vulnerability and love behind all of that, because you, the audience, including myself, are getting something from that. It's an inspiration. So share that love, you know, share Jack Stafford, Stafford, and or podsongs.com. And I wanted to ask you, what about Michael Franti? What about him? Have you interviewed him at all? He's got some incredible music.
No, your head? He's a musician.
Yeah. And it's all positive. Yeah. Write his, go check him out. He's amazing. And it's Franti, the Spearheads. He's got incredible music. I think that would be a great collab with you two.
Oh, great.
Something's popping up for me intuitively, so I thought I'd share that with you.
The Spearheads.
Okay. Yep. Spearheads and Michael. And his last name is Franti.
All right. I'll tell him you sent me.
Oh, his music's, I think it's really going to be in alignment with what you're doing.
Wow. Thank you so much.
Oh, you're welcome. I'm excited to hear what comes of it.
Yeah.
Yes. You follow the intuition. So genuine and authentic to, well, you know what, that's a good message for everybody, right? Versus mm-hmm. just the songwriters of the world, but being a human, genuine and authentic, having that service mindset, don't fake it. If it doesn't resonate with you, get something that really does, because mm-hmm. there is a ton of opportunities out there, and find that for yourself. I know that vulnerability, the authentic and genuineness of your message and what you're doing with podsongs.com. And I love that you're bringing in other artists from all over. That's going to be really magical. That's going to be fun to witness and see and how that evolution happens. So with that, anything else? Are you promoting anything else other than your deeper and then that video we've got to go and see?
Well, if I had any tip for anyone, it would be, because going back to my, so I was 333, and then I found Into the Serpent, and then I was Nehemiah Davis, you know, these amazing talks on YouTube, mysticknowledge.org. And he also has a library of mystic knowledge books from the Theosophical Society and deep, you know, yoga literature. And his master was Dr. George King, who was a Yorkshireman, and he was a master of yoga. So there was me in India, Englishman in India, getting introduced to a Yorkshireman via an American. So now I've joined this spiritual organization. I know, it's crazy. So now I'm in the...
Right?
Yeah. I wouldn't make this up, would I? So now I'm in this organization called the Aetherius Society. Aetherius, A-T-H-R-I-U-S. It means someone who travels through the ethers. It's kind of a mix of, it's a cosmic religion. So it's a mix of ufology and Christianity. So it's going to be a difficult to many people to digest, because you're either in one camp or the other, or think both camps are crazy. But the teachings are really incredible. And I've studied hundreds of hours now, and I can really just say that was something you should check out if you've been looking for truth, you know.
Okay.
That's really a center of truth.
And what's that called for you?
Aetherius.org.
Okay.
It's the Aetherius Society.
Okay. Hey guys, whatever resonates, and it's, and audience always knows this. I bring guests on for this fact, new thoughts, new perspective, new ideas. It could be created as a new you. You take what resonates for you. There's no
judgment.
Absolutely not. So Benny and I would like to play. We're going to end the show just a little bit early because we want to honor you and promote and love on one of your songs, if that's all right with you.
Go on then.
Oh, just go on then. I want to remind everybody, well, we've got a few more minutes, but who we've been talking to, it's Jack Stafford. You can go to podsongs.com for those of you on YouTube, and I'm waving to you and you can see my fingers going podsong.com. Radio World, obviously there's Jack there. Radio World, Jack, J-A-C-K, and Stafford with two Fs as in Frank, S-T-A-F-F-O-R-D. And he is all about being of service through his music, that self-help songwriter. I love that title. It's a self-help, but it's you know, self-help goes so broad, and sometimes there's going to be a negative connotation to it. But I love how you are bringing these guests of service, one, to be an example, two, to change your mindset and neural pathway through that act of service, and then also giving back again to the people that you have interviewed. And I love that. And not only giving back, but doing it from a passion, from a genuine and authentic, that's true to you. It's songwriting. And I love it.
I get so much back. If you give, you get twice back.
Oh, yeah. But that's not why we do it. We just do it to do it, because we love it. We love to love. What are you grateful for?
Well, this interview.
Oh.
This fantastic interview. That's all I can think of now.
Thank you. And your music, of course, and Benny.
Yeah, just an opportunity. You know, we're in the middle of this pandemic. You know, and from these problems, always give me more problems, because from problems come solutions that you would never have had before. I wouldn't have come up with this idea for Pod Songs or without having been locked in my house for 2 months. So,
I love that you brought that up, because And that's an adjective to describe. I call it opportunities, because opportunities don't have an emotional charge, right? And it's the mindset coaching me. It's that, you know, difference, you know, changing the mindset. And it's all of you creating opportunities in your life. Yes, you've had an opportunity, and now you're in an incredible space and place where you can create all this beautiful music. And then that evolution of that, look at that, Jack. Look what you're doing for the opportunities and the inspiration, not only for other artists, because you're doing something different and new and fresh, and it's being of service. Yeah. I mean, it's beautiful.
Wow. 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 Even I'm impressed.
Drum roll, please. I love it. But thank you for standing in the rink and shining your light and being of service and showing up in that way, because it's not always easy. And guys and gals in the podcast world and Spotify, we need to get these followings and listen over and over and over again. Help support the people like Jack and, of course, myself too. But all right, we're going to end a little bit early, and we are going to play the song Background Worry. And this is Jack Stafford. And for those of you who want to get a hold of him, you can go to podsongs.com, get all the information at SueLundquist.com. And until next time, each of you are a gift. Get out there and share yourself with the world.
Cool. It's all planned.